Okay. Hello, I'm Alex from A.P.Ink. So I'm moving on to the next prompt for YouTuber Sealemon's 30-day fruit challenge. I forgot to look to see what prompt I'm on, just in case you're following along. I'm looking that up right now. I'm on prompt 26, which is tomato. So I've got a piece of sketchbook paper, some colored pencils, and I'm just gonna pick out colors I think will work for this. So many of these have been using the same colors. Okay, I think I'll go with these ones. Actually, I think I'll switch out the blue for brown. So I've got orange, yellow, green, red, and brown. So I am gonna try and duplicate this kind of bunch of three on the vine. So I'm just gonna get into this. For any that don't know, because there is, I guess, a debate that may or may not still be going on as to whether or not tomatoes are fruits or vegetables. They are considered a fruit because of how they grow. They're a berry. They do tend to be a bit more savory than sweet, which is why, at least here in America, when we use tomatoes to make sauces, we tend to add a bit of sugar to I can't think of the right word for it, but to kinda go against the acidity in the tomato. Anyways. Hello. I'm working on the next prompt in YouTuber Sealemon's 30-day fruit challenge. I think I already did a fruit, dragon fruit. Yeah, they're tomatoes. Trying to get the layout. I just got out a fresh yellow green. This one is a bit too hard to try to sharpen. You bought tickets for like a concert or something? Oh, a UFC event? That's cool. Is anybody big supposed to be fighting? For when you're going? One of your favorites? That's cool. I don't know how that kind of thing works. Are you able to... Do they do any kind of like meet and greet? Do you get to like meet with the fighters? Get autographs or whatever? You did a fan art of him? Just about the fight. That's still cool, though. Okay, I think I'm gonna go with this, so it's not 100% the same. But I think it's close enough. Excuse me, I will be right back. Still looks good. Thank you. I did. It looks like an old anime. The style of it. I think I saw, now I gotta look it up again. I think I saw that ranking of the kids kings it was like early 2000s. But the art style looked older than that. 2017. Maybe it's just the style they chose. You think the characters are well written? I think I saw that some of the episodes are available on YouTube. I haven't had the chance to watch anything yet. Have you ever watched the old Voltron cartoon anime? Have you ever seen any of the, shoot, what was it? Speed Racer? Both kind of, I don't know how to say this the right way, but I think both are kind of dated, at least in terms of the art, kind of the same as Ranking of the Kings, like the art style. I'm not saying anything about the storyline, I'm just specifically talking about the art. I don't even mean that in a bad way. Yeah. Ghost in the Shell. Eon Flux. That kind of art style. As opposed to, like, Sailor Moon? Where, I swear, the head is, like, as big as my pinky, and then the body is, like, this long. Like, as long as my hand. Which is a bit ridiculous. I know they're playing up for the audience, but, like, have you ever seen Eon Flux? Or, like, heard about it? I don't know how much some of these cartoons, shows, go across nations. The live adaptation of Pinocchio? I haven't seen it. Yeah. That wasn't the main character, though. The lady with the hands for feet, that was a side character. The movie was based on a cartoon. If you get the chance, you should try to look up the cartoon. They explain how she lost her feet. The movie, live adaptation of Eon Flux did not really go into a lot of the detail. I mean, I guess it was supposed to just be about Eon, but the cartoon, I don't know, there was a specific feel, I think, that they were going for with the art style for the cartoon, the show. Okay, I think I am going to add some blue to this just to help push some of the shadow further back. I kind of feel like, in a way, stories like Hunger Games, and maybe Divergent may have kind of borrowed from Aeon Flux. Just my opinion. If you're familiar with either of those franchises. Yeah, I don't understand why they didn't finish Divergent. I really doubt that there wasn't money there for it. Is that the actress's name? Thank you. Thank you. Are you just hanging out, or are you drawing too? That's Sakura. Thank you. Cool. It's so easy to fall down a rabbit hole when you're searching stuff online. Yeah, I think the only thing I don't miss about old media players, the tangible ones, is the how many of them used to skip. If you ever had a CD player. I think it's interesting how records, they kind of went away and then they came back a couple of times, but a lot of artists now are actually selling brand new music on records. Makes me wonder if CDs are ever going to make a comeback. I mean, depending on the artist you like, musicians, whatever, you can still buy their music on CD. It's been a while, but yeah, I've seen Lord of the Rings. I'm trying to think. Like I said, it's been a while. I guess I don't remember that right off. Because of this? Or are you looking at something else? Try and actually get a sharp point on this. Try and get some definition on these leaves, I guess, right here, so they don't all blend in. The difference between what it looks like here versus the camera is something. Okay, so the reference versus what I did. I don't know if it really comes off as tomato. But I think I'm gonna leave this one here. Thanks, Asakura, for hanging out. Thank you to anybody else who watched or watches. If you would like to catch me live, please make sure that you're following me and that your notifications are turned on so that you're notified for the next time I go live. But other than that, enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you. Bye.